अस्सलामु अलैकुम माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. माई नेम इज़ सहर एंड आई एम योर इंग्लिश टीचर. टुडे वी विल रीड यूनिट नंबर 3, रॉबिन्सन क्रूसो. आई विल रीड द चैप्टर एंड एक्सप्लेन इट टू यू. आई होप यू ऑल विल फाइंड इट वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. For this, you need to open your OME Oxford Modern English books and kindly keep a lead pencil in your hand so that you can underline all the difficult words you are going to find in the chapter. Open page number 28, unit number 3, Robinson Crusoe. Robinson Crusoe is the name of a book by Daniel Defoe. Daniel Defoe was born in 1660. So in this first paragraph, actually, they are giving you introduction of author of this book. Robinson Crusoe is name of a book and it is written by Daniel Defoe. Daniel Defoe was born in 1660. His father was a butcher. Underline the word butcher. Butcher means a man who cuts or sells meat. And Daniel Defoe worked at a number of trades before he started to write at the age of 40. What was his profession before he started to write? He was a trader. He wrote poems and occasionally wrote criticism of the government. Sometimes he was sent to prison. When he was nearly 60, he wrote the story of Robinson Crusoe. At what age he wrote this story? He wrote this book, Robinson Crusoe, when he was 60 years old. It was a great success and has been popular with the children ever since. So they are telling you that Robinson Crusoe is a very famous book and it is very popular among the children since now. It is the first great novel, English novel. In this short piece from the book, Robinson Crusoe tells us how he became shipwrecked. What does shipwrecked mean? Underline the word shipwrecked. Shipwrecked means a person who had faced ship destruction. So basically, in this chapter, Robinson Crusoe will tell you the troubles he had faced after he got shipwrecked. Let's start the story. We started off on our voyage in good weather, although it was very hot. Students, you have to note down the word we here. The word we explains that Robinson Crusoe was not alone on this voyage. He had some friends or some of his companions with him. Underline the word voyage. The meaning of this word is given in your words to know column, last word, voyage. Voyage, a journey by sea or air, especially one to a distant place. So whenever you travel to a distant place with the help of an airplane or ship, that journey is called voyage. After about 12 days, however, a violent tornado came from the north. Underline the word violent and you will find it in the words to know column, second last word, violent. Using physical force to cause hurt or damage. So what does violent mean? A swear, okay? And tornado is the fourth last word given in your words to know column. A destructive funnel shaped rotating column of air, a windstorm. So what happened after 12 days of their journey? After about 12 days of their journey, a severe tornado, a funnel-shaped rotating column of air came from the north. The waves rose high, the skies were black, and the wind howled through the sails. Howled means to make a deep, loud sound. Two members of the crew were washed overboard. Crew means staff. So two members of the staff of the ship were drowned. And after a day or two, the ship began to leak. We changed our course. What is the meaning of course? Course means way. And sailed out of the hurricane. But the next day, a second terrible storm attacked us. What is the meaning of hurricane? You can look into your words to know column. Fourth word from the start, hurricane, a severe tropical storm. So what he is saying? He is saying that we changed our way, but what happened? On the second day, a severe tropical storm attacked them. We could see the shore of some unknown land, but the sea was very rough. The rain dashed down. Dashed down, you have to underline this word. Dashed down is actually a phrase which means to fall down or to pour down heavily. So he is explaining that we could see, they were able to see the shore of a land. Shore means the dry land. They were able to see that dry place, but they were unable to go to that dry place. Why? That dry area. Why? Because the sea was very rough. Why the sea was so rough? Because of that storm. And the rain was also pouring down heavily. Turn over the next page. And we were afraid to approach close to the land. Our only hope was to clamber. First of all, you have to underline the word clamber. Clamber means to climb with difficulty. As you know how to climb or jump. So clamber is a kind of jump which you take with great difficulty. So what was their last hope? Our only hope was to clamber into a small boat and try to row to the shore. Their last hope. There was no other way out. Their last hope was to climb with great difficulty into another small boat in order to reach the dry land. Four of us managed to get the boat into the sea and we jumped into it. We rowed with all our might. Might means force. So he is saying that four of us means one, he is stating about himself, and three other members were able to get into the other boat. But what happened? They were trying to move that boat forward with all the might. Might means force. But the waves were like mountains. Waves were like mountains means waves were so huge. Waves were so high. We struggled on, but at last a gigantic wave greater than all the others hurled. Underline the word hurled. Hurled means to throw something with force, with great force. Our little boat into the air and it sank beneath us. He is saying that we were struggling to row our boat towards the dry land. But what happened? At last, a gigantic wave, underline the word gigantic and write down very large wave came, which was greater than all the other waves, and it hurled their boat. Hurled means it threw their boat away and the boat sank beneath them. I'm a good swimmer, and for an hour and a half, I battled in that stormy sea. Robinson Crusoe is explaining about himself. He is saying that he was a good swimmer and he battled, he tried to struggle in that stormy sea. As I caught sight of the coast, a huge wave would lift me up and carry me out to the sea again. I tried to reach the shore again and again, and I was thrown away by the raging seas again and again. Raging, underline the word raging. Raging means angry sea. The sea was angry. There was a storm. He is explaining the condition that I again and again try and struggled and battled to reach by swimming. Through swimming, he was trying to reach the dry land, but the waves, the raging sea, the angry sea was again and again trying to throw him back. At last, I was hurled towards the shore and fell down exhausted on the sand. Exhausted means extremely tired, very tired. When you do work, when you continuously do some work and then you feel extremely tired. So because he was battling in that stormy sea, so now he was exhausted. He is saying that when I reached the dry land, I fell down exhausted on the sand. The night was dark without a star in the sky, and I knew that lying on the sand would be dangerous. So why he is saying that the night was dark? Because there was no star in the sky. I crawled away from the sea as fast as I could and came to some bushes and trees. What is the meaning of the word crawled. Underline this word. Crawled means to move forward with the help of your hands and knees. So he is saying that lying on that sand in the dark night would be dangerous. Why? Because there might be some dangerous or wild creatures over there. So what he did? He just moved himself forward with the help of his knees and hands and moved himself towards some bushes and trees. I didn't know what wild animals there would be in the forest. So I climbed up one of the trees and made myself comfortable between two great branches. There I slept the night as well as I could. He is saying because of the wild creatures, he just, in order to keep himself safe, he climbed up a tree and he made himself comfortable between how many branches? Between two branches, and he slept between those branches. In the morning, I looked out across the sea and there was our ship a quarter of a mile away from the shore. When in the morning he woke up, he was able to look at his ship. His ship was only a mile away from that land. I came down from the tree and found a stream where I drank some of cool fresh water. When he came down from the tree where he slept the last night, he found a stream, and what he did there, he drank some cool and fresh water. I lay down and slept again because he was so exhausted, he was tired. So he, after drinking water, he again lay down and slept. The sun was high. Turn over the page. The sun was high in the sky when I woke up. He is saying that when he woke up, it was daytime. The sun was high. I resolved to go out to the ship and to try and bring back some things which would be useful to me on the island. So the next morning, what he did? He resolved. What is the meaning of resolved? Resolved means decided. So he decided to go back to the ship. Why he decided so? Because he wanted to bring some things which would be useful to him on this island. What he did after waking up? I resolved. Resolved means to decide. Okay, to take some decision. What he decided after waking up? He decided to go back to that ship. Why? To bring some useful things from the ship which can be helpful to him on that island. I plunged into the sea. Plunged, underline this word. Plunged mean to dive. I plunged into the sea mean I dived into the sea and made for the ship. Because he was a good swimmer, so when he dived into the ship, he swam towards the ship. At last, after a hard swim, I managed to reach it and discovered a rope hanging over the side. He is saying that after a hard swim, he was able to reach the ship. With great difficulty, I pulled myself up the rope and reached the deck. With the help of a rope, he reached the deck. What is deck? Deck is actually the floor of the ship. The storm had damaged everything. Now he is explaining you the situation of the ship. The storm had damaged everything. There were broken masts. Their masts are actually the long pillars, okay, attached to the ship. And torn sails. Sails are the piece of the cloth. So what was the condition after the storm? All the things in the ship were destroyed. The long pillars, which are called masts, all those masts were broken and the sails were torn. I went down into the cabins and found an axe. What he found from the cabins? He found an axe. On deck again, I cut the masts and ropes and made myself a small raft. I managed to get this raft into the sea and tie it to the vessel and a rope. So what he did with all those broken masts and broken sticks? He made himself a small raft. What is a raft? A raft is actually a wooden board. I found some of the seamen's boxes on board and filled them with stores, bread, rice and cheese. All these I piled on the raft. What is the meaning of piled? Piled means collected. So what he did, he found there some useful things like bread, rice and cheese. So what he did, He collected all these things on the raft, that wooden board. And having found a broken oar, what is an oar? Oar is actually a wooden stick which helps a boat or a small raft to move forward, okay, by pulling water. I cast off from the vessel and started for the shore. So with the help of that oar, he was able to move his raft forward and he was able to reach the shore, the dry land. When I reached the sand, I carried the things up onto the dry land. So when he reached the island, what he did? He carried all these useful things, bread, rice, and cheese with him on the island. The next morning, I walked along the shore and up a little hill. From there, I could see that I was on an island. So the next morning, he climbed up a little hill and he was able to see the island. I was a prisoner without a friend in the world. How he felt when he was watching that island? He felt himself like a prisoner because he was all alone there. He had no friend over there. There was no one living on the island but wild beasts. So students, till here you have to read the chapter again and again and listen to this explanation so that you all can understand it well. Inshallah, in the next lecture, I will read the chapter afterwards. Thank you. Bye-bye.